My name is Bear Grylls. Now, my challenge is to survive one of the most treacherous landscapes on Earth, Alaska. I'm going to show you the skills you need to survive.
Hey, look at this. Brilliant. Oh, this is great, look. This could well be the key for me getting out of here, if this thing floats.
One of the core lessons of survival is to be open to every opportunity, and this boat provides me with one. I just need a paddle, and this spade will do the job. The boat is old, and the sea is full of ice. On foot, it could take me days to walk around these endless craggy inlets. Old boats, though, are often a risk. But at the moment, it's my best option. As I continue, I come across a bay full of sea ice. And as I go on, the ice thickens. Soon ice blocks are all around me. They may look magnificent, but they can cause serious damage to even a large boat. You can only ever see the tip of an iceberg, as 90% are submerged. As ice melts faster when it comes into contact with water, eventually the bergs become top-heavy and roll, often violently.
I'm a bit worried, because all this ice is beginning to close in a bit now. And it's so disorientating trying to work out where you are. Just because all of these things move with the current. What looks like a gap 1 minute, then suddenly like closes up in front of you. You can see how much damage these things can do. I don't know how well this little skiff's holding up here.
The constant banging into the ice is taking its toll on the boat, and freezing water is seeping in.
If you see that spit of land, all that gravel, that's my new boat.
The camera crew are in protective clothing. I am not. At first it's a trickle, but soon it's gushing in. It looks like my only option is to swim.
This thing is just going now.
But first, I've got to take some clothes off, or they're going to really weigh me down.
It completely goes. Don't sink yet, don't sink yet. It's just that tiny little bit of buoyancy keeping it up. I've got about 200 metres, I reckon, to reach the shore. But this thing is on its last leg, just that buoyancy in the bow. Wow, that's...
The shock of hitting this water makes me gasp, and the danger is sucking in a big lung full of air and water, and that's how people drown. My heart rate has gone through the roof, and I'm beginning to hyperventilate. In some people, this can induce a heart attack.
That's gonna get this cotton off.
Cotton literally sucks the heat out of your body. It's a killer when wet. If you get soaked in a cotton t-shirt and a pair of jeans in conditions like this, you need to get them off fast. You'll survive longer naked.
And this stuff is all glacial water. And seawater freezes at a much lower temperature than normal water, so effectively, that's like colder than ice.
My fingers and toes are so numb. I need to get the blood flowing back. My jacket has stayed dry in the backpack, and this will save me.